Hello guys and welcome to episode 25 of the Outer Rim Smugglers. My name is Iggy.
Hi guys, my name is Bjarni. I'm going to go over Texx's list here. He's flying a Darth Vader with Adrenaline Rush, TIE X1, Advanced Targeting Computer and Engine Upgrade. And then we have Rear Admiral Chirino with Veteran Instincts, Rebel Captive, Gunner, Isenizard and Engine Upgrade.
Yep, we have a mirror match here because Morgan is running almost an identical squad. He's running Darth Vader with Predator, TIE X1, Advanced Targeting Computer and Engine Upgrade, and then Captain Oiken with Predator, Rebel Captive, Gunner, Isain Assart, Engine Upgrade and the Dauntless title.
Righty. Exciting.
Yep. And this of course is the final match in the Team Covenant Aces League that Calvin Tiberius is running.
All right.
Morgan has the initiative. He's playing from the bottom with the red dots and Texx playing with the yellow dots.
Good.
Interesting to see the asteroid placement because Morgan puts all three asteroids in the center and Texx puts all his
in the corners.
In the corners. So yeah. Even though the lists are similar, the asteroid placement is very different.
Yeah.
It's probably because Oiken works better if there are fewer possibilities for the enemy to fly into.
Yeah.
I guess that's why Morgan places his astro attack that, and you can see in the opening that Morgan ships bump each other and doesn't move at all.
Yeah.
While Texx moves up a bit. And again for the second turn, Morgan is not moving at all.
Guess he's waiting for a certain distance before he pounces. Yep.
Yep. Oiken of course moves first and bumps Vader, and then Vader takes the 2 turn, and next turn he can take a 2 turn also, and yep. Then they will be in kind of formation.
Setting up for a formation. Yeah. It's a clever way to start.
Yeah, Texx does a similar thing. He's gonna take his crafts either way, each way of the debris field in the bottom left corner. So with all those maneuvers, it looks like they could just have set up directly across each other and flown like this because it's the same thing. Essentially,
yeah.
I like this move a lot from Oiken because he's guaranteeing a bump in next turn unless Vader turns right, and he's not going to be turning right. So, good job by Morgan.
Yeah, it can be when you have a ship like Oiken where you want to bump, it can be very good. And it can also be kind of restraining because you're always trying to get that bump.
Yeah.
You're trying to use the points.
You have to use his ability sparingly, not forced all the time, because sometimes actions are better.
Yeah.
The decimators are in range one of each other, and with no agility dice for defense, this could hurt a lot. You can see that the first crit of the game, a minor explosion that does not go off, hits the Rear Admiral. And here we see the bump on Vader, and he takes a point of damage. Morgan's Vader moves into block, and Texx's Vader stops right in front of him, but he's not going to stay there. He'll boost out of his arc.
Yeah.
So neither of the Vaders will have shots, and both decimators have bumped, so no actions there, but still
shooting each other.
Still shooting at each other at range one.
Yeah.
Texx obviously activates his ice art because he's Yes, down to hull. No focus die, focus for him on the die, so he can't use Shirno's ability. And of course, both decimators have rebel captive, so they will stress each other. Gunner helps Oikon there because the first four dies yielded no hits at all.
Congratulations on the new episodes, Flight Academy.
Yeah, if you guys haven't been watching our channel lately, you could just check out the Flight Academy episodes. We got two out and another one coming on Sunday. So it's gotten quite a good reception.
Awesome.
Both players repositioning a bit here. So we'll see if we'll have any shots this turn.
So I always want to see this in a mirror match where players are jousting, where they're how they turn around and.
Yeah, because it's when you have only two ships on your side, you want to be focusing fire with them. So even though one can turn around fast, and if the other one can't, you have to wait for it.
Time your results.
Yeah, definitely.
Find it when you're flying the IGs, the robots.
Yeah.
And you're flying crisscross. You have to time your assaults.
Yeah.
Correctly, so that both of your ships are in arc are in range at the same time.
Absolutely. And I think the way you fly the robots is probably the best way. You keep them apart and then you kind of pinch the opponent.
Yeah. Been having a lot of fun with the lawnmower.
Yep. For those of you who don't know, do you want to tell us what the lawnmower list is?
The lawnmower is five Y-wings with auto-blaster turrets.
Yep. It has been mowing down Sundirfells and Whispers in Iceland.
Yep.
We've been having a lot of fun with it.
A dreaded list.
Yep.
They gave it a name, yep. The lawnmower.
Always nice when your list is named by the opponent after a defeat.
Yeah, I already gave it a name. I called it the Wi-Fi.
Yeah.
But
the lawnmower stuck.
Yeah, the lawnmower stuck.
Yeah. Oikon was pixels away from hitting the debris field, but after checking it out, both players agreed that it was not on. This one, however, is on, but he did the wrong move. He dialed in a two turn, but actually moved it to three turn, and they're going to correct that now.
Yeah, that's much better.
Here we see some might say clever use of target lock as a range finder, and then boosts into range. We were talking about it before the show, Bjarni and I, that we didn't quite like how people are abusing the target locks to find out the range.
Target locks and boost attempts. Failed boost attempts.
Yeah, to check out where the ship will be next turn. So we were even thinking that perhaps failed target locks attempts would result in no action for the ship that turn.
Yeah.
Don't know if that's fair or not, but it's a food for thought.
Yeah, we should perhaps try it out sometimes and see how it affects the game.
Yeah, I think it will definitely in those situations where you are not quite sure, you will just have to take the risk of target locking or doing another action. So the ships are now facing each other after the repositioning, and this is where you see expert flying, because both ships are in a similar position, even though they came from a different spot. Well flown by both players.
Yeah. Admiral taking another hit.
Yeah, and here Oikon sets up for the bump next turn, probably.
Yeah.
Let's see what Texx does with his ships. He chooses to move his waiter away. And the Rear Admiral will bump into Oikon.
Would a card similar to Veteran Instincts be a good idea? A card that will give you extra points for taking off pilot skill? Like changing Oikon into a pilot skill 2?
That's a good question. I think sometimes lowering the pilot skill is a benefit, so if you would get points for doing it, it would be like a double benefit sometimes.
Yeah.
So, yeah. What would you call it? Rookie instinct.
Rookie instinct.
Perhaps.
Straight out of the academy.
Yeah. Where Admiral takes a double crit here, a direct hit, and damaged cockpit, so he's now at pilot skill 0. So he will actually get to move out of Oikon's bump before Oikon can bump him. Meanwhile, Oikon puts a damage on the enemy waiter. The only problem I see with, obviously, you can't play this list, either of these lists, because they are using cards from the raider that is not out yet. The only thing I would miss is I love the waiter crew card on a Decimator. 360 for the waiter effect against hard hitting targets that are hard to hit, like Sundir Fellis.
Yeah.
I love that.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Although the three crew cards currently on each Decimator, Isard, Gunner, and Captive, Rebel Captive, is nothing to sneeze at.
Gunner not doing much in this situation unless you get no hits at all.
Yeah, while the Decimators are firing at each other, but once they start shooting at the enemy waiters with three agility dice,
yeah,
it will matter.
But I will imagine that this is Gunner is of course really good against IGs, because
yeah,
you're taking away the tokens and
yeah, you can put them in this classic spot. Do I spend the token or do I take one hit?
Yeah.
And even though the IGs are hard to take down, they only have 8 hull points, so each
yeah,
hit they take is like a minor victory.
Yeah. 4 shield and 4
hull points, yeah.
Hull points.
Here we see the guys are again repositioning, and again it's very well done by both players. Navigating the outward field expertly. Advanced targeting computer hits kicks in here, so 2 hits and it's evaded.
2 hits.
Yep. And Texx waiter tries to put a crit on the enemy Oikon, but it's evaded. He evades 2 times there with his token from Isard. And in return, it takes a direct hit from Icon. Things looking pretty grim for Texx. Texx of course won the Galactic Cup that Mr. Froggies was running. And since we were talking about the Flight Academy, Texx is a member of the council there that helps us out. So we appreciate that.
Yeah, you have a lot of experienced players that are advising.
Yeah, we have a game about planning phases where we sent a lot of good players the pictures that they and they set us what they would do in those situations, and then we offer the public to try themselves out against those great players.
Yeah. That's an excellent idea.
And the first of those will be shown on episode 3 that will be coming out next Sunday.
Sweet.
The same day as our own regionals.
Yeah.
We are looking forward to that. Still debating on what lists we are going to take.
Yeah.
And since this episode will be published before that, we are not going to be giving anything away.
Nope. But my Although list might begin with the letter L.
Yes, probably. And I'm probably going to be playing with...
that one.
Yeah, that one, yeah. So be aware. So this game is drawing to a close.
Yeah, doesn't look very good for Texx. Nope. I was rooting for him.
Yep. Morgan is, for those who don't know, the runner-up from Worlds 2014 and... he's been playing very well in this tournament, so...
Yeah. Excellent flying, but I think most of it, a large chunk of it, why the situation is like it is right now, is because of dice difference.
Yeah, I also think Morgan has been flying marginally better, and I think Oikon's effect has been... has had a good effect on the game. It has been... a bigger factor than Rear Admiral's one, and also the EPTs, because Morgan has Predator on both ships, and I think that's the main difference.
Yeah.
And of course that helps with the dice. So this has been the Outer Rim Smugglers. My name is Siggy.
I'm Bjarni. See you guys.
See you guys later. Dum 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 dum. Dum 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 dum